Well, we have special features that make us unique. A tattoo is a form of expression, but it can be a window into a person's identity.
Yeah, it's why law enforcement document them when a person is arrested. WCBI's Victoria Bailey talks with Winston County deputies to find out what officers can learn from a little ink. She joins us in the studio with more. Victoria.
Hair samples and fingerprints are just a few methods that law enforcement use to find out a person's identity. But I learned today if the body's got a tattoo, it might just tell officers what they need to know to make a positive ID. Identifying a suspect or victim's body is no easy task.
Depending on the circumstances, it can be extremely difficult when you find a body to figure out who that person is. Weather conditions, where the body was left, that sort of thing will play a heavy role in what sort of evidence is remaining.
Winston County Sheriff Jason Pugh says for his department, tattoos are one of the most important identifiers.
Everybody that's booked into our correctional facility, a list is made of the tattoos on that person at the time of their arrest. Some of these folks are arrested several different times over the course of their life. So if we find that tattoo on a person and we believe it may be this person and they have been in our system, then we can look back and see if that person did have that particular tattoo on their body at the time of death.
Since no crime scene is the same, law enforcement must work fast if the tat is going to be of any use to an investigation. Just ask Columbus Forensic Lab Director Austin Shepard.
Tattoos will typically survive on skin as long as the skin survives. So in hot, humid environments like you have in Mississippi and Alabama and kind of the deep south, decomposition rates, especially in the summer, are really, really, really high, really fast. You know, someone can completely decompose in a few days. Sometimes it may take up to a couple of weeks. But of course, once the skin's gone, the tattoo's gone.
Pugh says fingerprints and DNA are still widely used in investigations, but a tattoo is like a picture. It says 1,000 words.
If the officers know how to read, it can be a roadmap, basically, of that person's life, so you can learn a lot about them.
Pugh goes on to say it can be determined whether a person's a part of a subculture, network of a gang, or a member of a hate group just from a tattoo. Andrea Joey,